Hey guys, do subscribe to Books on Toast. It's youtube.com/books on toast. Do you like books? Do you like toast? Put it on each other and eat them for breakfast. My name is Sorabh Pant.
Please do not eat books for breakfast.
That's my sister Meghna Pant, and she's an author, a world-renowned author. She's been nominated for the Pulitzer Prize in my books.
Of course. And I've also won the Nobel Prize for Literature.
Six Nobel Peace Prizes. Yeah.
You don't win a Peace Prize for Literature.
You can, if your book causes peace.
World peace. I don't think books are that powerful yet.
Yeah. If you throw the book at your enemy and he's like, oh, peace is better than your book. So she's written multiple books. The first book was 1.5 Five, then was Happy Birthday, then was Trouble with Women, which is published in Juggernaut. And now you have forthcoming Feminist Rani.
In which you're also there.
I'm there as, there's a photograph of me. I'm the centerfold. You open and it's me going like, who wants this? So this is Unlikely Pairings and this is Raksha Bandhan week.
Yeah. Yeah.
So hence, we're like, hey, what better pair of high achieving, you know, good looking, talented, amazing, serendipitous
siblings.
Siblings.
Do you remember what you do every Rakhi?
I used to, but
you just took money from my wallet last week. Literally, just last week.
No, did I?
Yes.
Oh no, but that's because you were giving it to me fakely and I took it.
But I was giving it to you as a joke, not for you to actually keep it.
You don't give money to someone fake, like as a joke. I keep it. We grew up reading a lot. I think I read because I had no friends, and you read because you were intelligent. I mean, you are still. I'm not saying that it's gone.
No, it's gone. Middle age has taken away my intelligence. No, but we read a lot of. Our home was always filled with books, and really good books, actually.
Yeah.
Like Somerset Maugham, I remember. Tagore.
And there's Somerset Dad also, but we never read that.
That is so bad. That is such a bad joke. Yeah. And obviously Shakespeare. And we read a lot of classics. And
why are you like going straight to like the hardcore? Like, what about the basic ones?
You want to talk about soggy biscuits again?
No, I'm talking about like we started off with like Enid, Blyton and stuff.
Yeah.
Enid,
oh my
Blyton,
God,
and
I loved Enid, Blyton.
And Asterix and all that stuff we started off.
Yeah. Enid, Blyton, Secret Seven.
Yeah.
Famous Five, and then Malory Towers was my favorite.
Yeah.
What was the Daryl, right? Rivers?
Something like that.
Yeah. Oh my God. I used to see myself in her as a girl.
Really?
Yeah. Very precocious and kind of short-tempered.
I think I was the only guy who ever read St. Clair's and Malory Towers because it was in the house.
Yeah. And because I used to devour it. So yeah. I think you kind of like just saw me.
So I read it because of you.
Yeah.
Which is weird.
What was your key takeaway?
I know, I used to like how every time they just have to sneak away for treacle pudding. I don't know why treacle pudding was always there. And when I grew up, I was like, I want to know what this treacle pudding shit is, man.
Have you ever tasted it?
No.
No, why? I think we're missing out on life.
Yeah, I want to try treacle pudding.
Okay, that's on our bucket list now.
But I remember Papa hates, used to hate Archie.
Why?
He used to hate Archie comics.
Are you serious?
Are you serious?
I love Archie. I don't remember this.
He used to hate it because he's like, ye pata nahi kya karte rehte hain.
Har
page mein koi na koi smooch kar raha hai ek dusre ko. This is constant complaint. He's like, aspects mein dekho aisa kuch nahi hota hai. I'm like, haan papa sahi bol raha
hai. Yeah, because they're like beating each other up with a fish. Are you serious? Yeah. I don't remember this.
He took away my books because of that. He's like, ye kya matlab, at least read something like he was
so
fine
funny
with like Asterix and Tintin and Tinkle and
non-smoochy books.
Yeah, non-smoochy books. Because Uncle Pye never smooched anyone in Tinkle. But what is the first genuine author you read? Like, who's the first?
I think it was Little Women. So after Daryl, I saw myself in Jo March, I remember.
Right.
Like, I don't know, she was everything I wanted to be growing up. I was like, you know, again, like intelligent, geeky, but also like, I think she reflected a lot of who I was at that time. Like, even short-tempered, tomboyish. So I think I saw myself a lot in her. Then of course, Scarlett O'Hara was who I wanted to grow up and be, Gone with the Wind.
Yeah.
I think that was the first all-nighter I pulled. I remember we went to Shimla, we'd gone for a summer vacation. I must have been 11 or something. And I stayed up the whole night. I couldn't put the book down.
You read Gone with the Wind as an 11-year-old?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
I don't know how I understood it. Who did you like when you were growing up?
I think the first book I ever read, which was like a, I mean, and I'm not whatever, whatever. I think yeah. P.G.Wodehouse I read when I was...
Yeah,
and I remember what happened also. I was 11 or 12. I just moved to a new school.
Yeah.
And I had no friends for the first 3 years because I've generally always found it hard to make friends.
Yeah.
And I went to the library because we had a full library in St. Mary's ISC and I found P.G.Wodehouse. I didn't understand anything that was happening. But yeah, I'm like, I could understand one out of every seven jokes.
Yeah.
And I just kept reading it because of that. So he was, I think, the first, this thing. So you read, you read Gone with the Wind, I read P.G.Wodehouse.
But that's really interesting because we grew up in our formative years reading the same books.
Yeah.
And then we just kind of like diverged.
Yeah.
Which is very interesting because then, because of that, our writing styles are also very different.
Yeah. Like so yours is good. Mine is like, kya ho raha hai is kitab mein, samajh nahi aa
raha. We published, you got published before me.
Yeah.
That's 2011, I remember.
But I think the only book we've read, the only book we've, I think, not read, but read since we became teenagers.
Yeah.
And enjoyed equally was the Harry Potter series. That's it. I don't think there's any...
Hitchhiker's Guide, I think we enjoyed.
I don't think you liked Hitchhiker's Guide?
Yeah. Strange, right?
That's damn good.
I really hate science fiction, but I don't know, I really enjoyed it.
That's damn funny.
Yeah, I actually even watched sat through the entire movie.
Yeah, it's fun.
Malgudi days was awesome.
I tried reading Tagore and I think I want to try it now. I don't know why we're being pretentious immediately in like the first 20 minutes. Like, I should try and read Tagore, you see. I think that chap has something. He has something to offer me intellectually.
No, Premchand also we read. Even in school, we were taught a lot of Premchand stories. So that was interesting. And then I think I was at St. Xavier's College. I remember that time, that's when the era of literary fiction in India with Indian authors really took off. So like Aravind, Adiga, Rohinton Mistry, Jhumpa, Arundhati Roy. So I think those years were when I was sort of submerged in these books, in literary fiction. I think for me, that's when I started reading and enjoying it.
I think, so I read Aravind Adiga much later, which is White Tiger. I loved. It was phenomenal.
It's phenomenal. Yeah.
And I just couldn't read Arundhati Roy. Because also, I realized I read very slowly. So if it like 70 pages takes me a long time, and if by that time it's like something crazy exciting hasn't happened, like I tried reading Fountainhead or Atlas Shrugged.
Oh my god, I love Ayn Rand.
I couldn't do it.
Oh yes, I remember. You couldn't. I loved her. It. Oh god, Howard Rock. Like if I meet a man like this, you know.
Really, it's just he's so selfish.
But I like that. It's not selfish. It's individualism.
What rubbish.
It's not
just selfishness.
It's about
just
putting
your selfishness.
No, because in India at that time, especially, we were always told that the individual is subservient to the society. And for the first time in my life, somebody was telling me that no, you have to put your own self and your own needs first. Right. And only when you realize your own potential will you realize the potential of the nation.
Gandhi ji ne bhi ye sikhaya tha.
Wo memo maine na miss kar diya. Kya kare?
But I remember, I think I was, I don't know which one it was, but she was describing some dude's thigh for like 4 pages. I'm like, I also have a thigh, I can just look down. What are you going on about this guy's thigh for so long? Like 4 pages, she's like, his thigh was this muscular and could hold. I'm like, shut up man, I don't care about this dude's thigh.
Okay, so what were you reading? So after P.G. Wodehouse.
I think I read, the first Indian author I read which I loved was Anurag Mathur's Inscrutable Americans. It was an easy read back then.
Book. Yeah, it was very easy.
I was actually fun because that time nobody was doing anything even close to just humor.
That's true.
There was Kushwant Singh and stuff like that before, but there was nobody like just writing like fun humor without, and I just, my brain is too small to deal with big thoughts.
What nonsense, your comedy is so intellectual.
Hardly.
Don't be so modest, it's just me.
That's fine, people are watching.
Oh yeah, I forgot.
I can't say anything positive about myself. They'll be in on it.
So this is very interesting. I feel like every phase of my life, I'm reading something different.
Right.
So as a kid, I read something different. Then in my formative years, I read like literary fiction. And then I started reading a lot of Indian authors. For the last decade, I've been reading like Indian authors who are not as well known, but literary Indian authors.
Like whom?
And there's so many. And these are the guys who should be like extremely famous. They are so talented. It is insane. You know, people keep coming and complaining that there's no good writing in India anymore, but there is. The problem is you're reading the best-selling authors and not the best authors.
Right.
So then don't blame the authors or the lack of literature. It's not literature. There's still amazing stories, well-written stories. But these authors don't know how to promote themselves. Or they don't have a marketing budget. They don't have MBA degrees. So they don't know how to present themselves or how to sell their books. So as a result, readers are only reading the best-selling guys.
Right.
Guys who have deep pockets or huge marketing budget, who know how to like sell themselves.
Which is also a skill. I mean, like,
it's, of course, like, I think but it's not a literary skill.
Yeah, I was talking to the guys at Crossword once.
Yeah.
And I was like, I did a show where somebody bought 30 copies of my book or something along with the show.
Yeah.
I'm like, kya farak padega 30 copies? He's like, sir, ek kitab bhi bik jaye na, bahut badi baat hai. There are two other books you're coming out with.
Yeah. So one is How to Get Published, which is a guide on how people can write, publish, and market their book. And the best part of the book, which I really personally love, is the last bit of the book, which has got essays and tips. With Jeffrey Archer, Twinkle Khanna, Shobha Dey, Durjoy Datta, a lot of the literary authors. So I'm very excited about this book because it's literally got my icons in the book giving out their secrets and tips. Yeah. And no book like this has been published in India, and it's being launched at JLF. So I'm very, very thrilled. And I wrote this book literally like while I was breastfeeding, these three books. And I think it's been the toughest thing that I've ever done with my feet. I was kind of bored. How much Netflix can you watch, right? You're stuck for 12 hours, you can't move. What do you do? I watched Netflix for the first 1 month and I was like, I can't do this to myself.
Yeah.
So I just started being super productive.
What is the third book?
The third book is Holy Text. So I'd done the Mahabharata in 100 tweets.
Right.
In 2014, and that had got more sort of attention than anything else I've ever written combined. Like the Oprah Book Club mentioned it, the Guardian UK.
Really?
Yeah, it was insane the kind of publicity I got, every major publication in India. And so I've written an ebook for Rupa, which contains all the three of the major holy Hindu texts in 100 sentences each.
Nice.
So anyone who's not been introduced to the Mahabharata, the Ramayana, or the Gita can pick up this book and in 15 minutes they know the entire story.
That's pretty cool.
So if you're young, if you don't have the bandwidth or the time to read like the heavy text, because otherwise these texts are very voluminous and intimidating. So it was
my using words like voluminous. Like you just throw it in, like slide it in, like voluminous. And earlier also used a word where I'm like, oh.
Should I say farrago of lies and misrepresentations instead?
So let's come to the books. What are you reading right now?
So yeah, like I was saying, non-fiction. Huh. So I read The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck, which is literally like, I think as I'm getting older.
I give so little of a fuck that I didn't read the book. So I've already read it.
I'm sure Mark will be very happy to hear that. No, but it's literally, you know, are you finding that as you're getting older, you just literally don't. No, also you don't seek other people's approval at all. Like, I've just become like that. I'm just like, I'm on my own person now. You clearly don't. No. I have hit a raw nerve.
I really want people to love me.
Of course, and they do.
So,
and I read The Power, which you gifted me.
And that's, I gifted you that?
Yeah.
Why would
you
I
like,
gift you that?
I'm not going to read this, so it's for you. Even though it's...
that's such a
you only give me books. Yeah, you always only give me books when you're like, this is not my genre, so you read it.
Yeah.
Although it's science fiction, actually, technically.
What?
But it's about women, like, empowering themselves. I love it. It's my kind of book.
Yeah.
So I think, what are you reading?
I'm reading very weird stuff right now. I'm reading a collection of short essays by Kurt Vonnegut.
Oh, okay.
And it is hilarious.
Yeah.
Like he's so god. It's literally reads like he's doing stand up.
Yeah.
And it's damn funny. And so Kurt Vonnegut was one of the first few sci fi guys where I'm like, this is brilliant.
Yeah.
He wrote a book called Slaughterhouse 5, which took me 7 tries to read.
Yeah.
And when I got
Did
done with it,
it,
I'm like, this is nuts. Wow. And so it's his collection of short stories. I genuinely think he was born in an era where they didn't have stand up.
Yeah.
But it's really well thought out, well crafted jokes.
Yeah.
And it's really cool. So I'm reading that. I realize I've got. I think all of us have, not ADHD, but like, we have so many things.
To distract us,
yeah. So I'm reading 8 books at the same time.
Yeah.
And I don't think I'll finish them till like the next 2 months.
So, you know, everybody keeps talking about this nowadays, the authors, they're like, we're not competing with one another anymore.
Yeah.
We're competing with like WhatsApp and Taylor Swift and...
What?
Yeah. Because you're
fighting
for people's time.
So you're saying your direct competition is Taylor Swift?
Literally. Apparently. No, because people would rather listen to a song or they'd rather be on WhatsApp or they'd rather watch Netflix than read a book.
But it's become easier to read a book now. I actually completely disagree with people saying that people don't read anymore. I actually think people are reading a lot.
Yeah.
It's just that we have 1.28 billion people in India itself. And
like
even though bookstores are struggling a bit, sales are still relatively high. So yeah. I completely disagree with people and authors saying that nobody's reading. I think, like, it comes back to your earlier point. People are reading the bestsellers and stuff like that because that's all in stock most of the time.
Yeah, it's most visible, right?
Yeah. Like, Sacred Games, for example, got a crazy boost of sales again now after the Netflix show.
Yeah.
And I think that's going to happen a lot more. It's
but
like
they, once, they did it so well.
But even then, like, even if you have Dharma's arm or whatever, they're trying to do Ashwin Sanghi's book or whatever it is.
Yeah, yeah.
I think that's going to boost off stuff. But I'm reading a lot of non-fiction. So I was reading all the biographies of all of our prime ministers.
Yeah.
And it's all fascinating. I was like, this is way more exciting to me than most fiction.
Yeah.
Like the whole, there's a book, The Half Lion, which is Narasimha Rao's biography, and it's fascinating about how India did our nuclear test.
Okay.
And like, which I think they covered in Parmanu or whatever.
Yeah.
But it's damn cool, man. I'm like, they actually have a red phone, they have a red button, and the stuff that goes on behind the scenes, and you're like, this is crazy. Like, even with accidental prime minister, so I'm reading a lot more non-fiction.
So yeah, you came up with The Wednesday Soul in 2011. See, I also know all your books. And then Under Delhi, I remember. So we've done something very interesting. We've had like back to back every year. We've either had a book or we've had a baby. Have you noticed since like 2011 for the last 7 years, we've been pretty productive, man.
But which of your books that you've written so far do you like the most, including the ones that are coming up?
I'm a short story fan. I love reading short stories. Like if you ask me who's my favorite author today, I'll be like Alice Munro, who just won the Nobel Prize for Literature. I've been reading her for like 10 years.
Peace Prize for Literature.
The Nobel Peace Prize for Literature. Because her books help bring on world peace.
Yeah.
So I love her work. Like, you know, there are moments in the story when you just stop to catch your breath. So for me, a story works.
Because you're reading it on the treadmill. You're like, this is a bad idea. Should have done this on the elliptical.
Yes, that's exactly what it is.
You know, I already know the comments that are going to be there on this.
What?
Which is going to be, there's going to be at least 3 people saying, this guy is not letting her talk. We don't want to hear your shitty jokes, bro. Sune tere YouTube pe alag se. Haan, so Alice Munro,
Alice Munro, then Adichie, of course. So she's my icon so right now. Oh my God.
DJ Adichie.
You cannot call yourself my brother if you don't know what.
He's like,
you know the whole literary world is turned over in its grave right now. I shall share the book.
Okay.
And this, you've seen her TEDx talk. She talks about feminism. She wrote the book, We Should All Be Feminists. I'm drawing a complete blank here. Dude, how can you be my brother and not know who she is?
I don't know.
She's literally the coolest writer of our generation worldwide.
You mean
she's
like Doug Stanhope? Wow. He's a stand-up comedian. You don't know who that is?
I barely know the Indian stand-up comedians except your friends.
True, I remember you met Biswa. You met Biswa and you were like, oh, my brother is a stand-up. And Biswa was like, yeah, I also.
I love Happy Birthday. It got
your
me like...
book.
No, we were talking about my book. I'm circling back to our conversation because we diverged so much. So I got like quotes from Chitra Banerjee Divakaruni, who I've grown up reading. She like loved my books. Namita Gokhale, Ashwin Sanghi, Jeet Hale, and I was like,
I know 3 out of those 5 people. 4 out of the 6 people. Whatever number was
3
that.
3 out of 4 people.
Sure. Huh.
And it got longlisted for the world's biggest short story prize. And it's like the University of Tennessee wanted it on its course. So it's got a... It was even nominated for the Sahitya Academy Yuva Puraskar, but I lost out because I'm now above 35.
I know.
You were there, right? When I got the call, I was so frustrated. I'm like, come on. The book came out when I was 32. But by the time it was nominated for the award, I was not...
Considered. It's not nominated. It's considered. Technically.
Thanks.
No, I mean, otherwise they'll come and say, this lady is lying. And because people are just hypersensitive these days. But I remember because I've never seen you regret your age more in my life.
Yeah, I've owned my age. I like love getting older and I'm like, God damn it.
It's okay, I'll give you the prize, Meghna.
And the next day, I was longlisted for the Commonwealth Short Story Prize, but not shortlisted. So all this happened within 12 hours of each other. And I'm like... These are the days where you question yourself as an artist. You're like, why do I do this?
You know what you should do? I've been wanting to do this for a long time where I want to host the world's best comedian awards
and give it to myself. The award.
Yeah, but I want to do a proper like presentation. Like I want to hire an auditorium even if it has no people in it and give myself the award. You should do that for
yourself.
Give
you the award.
No, you should do it for yourself.
No, I'm not psychotic. I still have some normalcy left in my life.
I think the difference between doing stand-up and doing a book is that I think stand-up is a brain and body exercise.
Yeah.
And a book is like a soul exercise.
It is, yeah.
And so even though you're I think the breakdown percentage-wise...
Oh my, you have like a whole statistical analysis of this.
I was just pretending like, let's take this to the next intellectual level. Yeah. 73%, 26%, I don't know, fine, whatever.
Yeah.
But dude, books takes, it's so much effort to get a book published.
And the actual returns are awful. You don't get paid.
Right.
You don't get read enough. So the only thing you're taking out of the book is the pride of having written a story well told.
So how did you get into writing?
How did I get into writing?
You picked up a pen and you were like, "Isse kya kare?"
I think because we read a lot and I identified with a lot of the characters, and I was always like, I need to recreate these kind of stories and characters, in my reality. And I think I wrote, like I told you, my first short story collaboration with a woman rapes a man.
Yes.
And it got published. I wrote it when I was 16, and it actually got published on the website called Fresh Lime Soda. That Parmesh, remember Parmesh Shani was
that
running?
That was his?
Yeah, that was his.
I don't know that.
Met him recently and he mentioned that he was running it. So I said, wow, this is a coincidence. So Fresh Lime Soda published it. And after that, I think I was kind of traveling the world. I was young. I wanted to experience the world. And I got settled down into real, like solid, the discipline of writing only in my late 20s when I was in New York. When I started doing...
I thought it was Switzerland because it's like...
Yeah, but really disciplined, as in hardcore, like, okay, I'm going to publish a book. So I was writing a lot of short stories, but I started writing my novel 1.5 when I was in New York. And I was attending a lot of writing workshops. And slowly my short stories started getting published in US magazines, literary magazines. That also took a while because I used to keep getting rejected and it was like an ego I was like, I have to.
You know, the first time I got a rejection, thing. So I when I was 21, I wrote a novel, which is Driving on a Zany Impulse.
Oh, yes, I remember that. The taxi driver.
Tell the story, I want to write it.
You still haven't written it.
It's an idea that I actually still want to write at some stage.
Okay.
So, I wrote it and I sent it to Penguin, the only publisher.
Yeah.
And they sent me a standardized format for the... So, they have... your book has been rejected for the following reason. And there were about 20 reasons listed, but they have to tick out whatever one. They ticked out like 7. So, I got rejected 7 times in one rejection. I'm like, shit, this is such a terrible... So, I
didn't send it. You can't be a good writer unless you've been rejected.
You can't be a good anything unless you're rejected.
True. You have to fail, fall, and then...
Yeah, that's our excuse.
Yeah. Let's tell ourselves that and weep into our pillows.
But it's so hard to sell books, man. I think like this, like Pawan sold 5,000 copies. It sounds like not that much numbers.
I think people don't know this, that to be a best-selling writer in India, you have to only sell 10,000 copies.
Nobody's confirmed this.
No, people have.
Nobody's confirmed this to me.
For literary fiction at least.
Yeah, but then what's the, like, if you're a bestseller, whether it's a literary fiction or a non-fiction or whatever, the numbers should be the same, right?
So I asked someone this question for my How to Get Published book, and he said, say if Chetan Bhagat sells 10,000 copies, that's considered a flop. But if a literary fiction author sells 10,000 copies, it's considered a bestseller.
That makes no sense.
Yeah, I know. There's no standard definition, but 10,000 is a benchmark. I think people get surprised that in a country of almost 3 billion people, only 10,000...
Oh, okay.
Not 3 billion, 1.3 billion.
Yeah.
That only 10,000 copies are considered a bestseller. I think that's something that comes as a surprise to new authors.
You know the book I'm going to write next whenever I do? It's going to be called International Bestseller.
The name of your book is going to be International Bestseller. And what is it going to be about?
I don't know. But I'll just be like, this book is an international bestseller. Go
just
fuck
keep
yourself.
It empty.
That's it. That's my book.
I'm sure there'll be a bestseller. People want to read empty pages.
So you have like 3 books out, which is coming out soon. And August, when is this one?
So 18th August is Feminist Rani. That's been launched by Penguin. It's a series of interviews with the top and most powerful voices of gender equality in India. We've got Gurmehar Kaur, Kalki, Aditi Mittal. We've got you also in it.
To break the flow.
To break the flow.
Well, it's smart people and then we have you.
No, you're a hardcore feminist. I haven't met many men who are such, who believe so much in it. In fact, you're really nice to women, like particularly nice. Even to your mother, to your wife, to your sister, you treat them as equals and that's a beautiful thing. I think we've also grown up in an egalitarian household. So
what's egalitarian?
our mother worked like our father.
Is that a diet?
As much as our father, and she also retired as chief commissioner.
I'm an egalitarian. I don't have gluten.
You're just a farag of lies. But so it's a series of interviews, and I'm very excited about that book actually. So looking forward to having that out, and I think we need to have this conversation on gender equality a lot more in India. So yeah, my point was that men have always felt like they are ancillaries to feminists, but it's not true. Like if you look back at India's history also, just give me a moment here. You know, we had like Raja Ram Mohan Roy.
just give me a moment. Because I was like,
because I can feel your eyes rolling. You're like, do I have to listen to this? But no, seriously, like Raja Ram Mohan Roy helped to abolish sati.
Right.
So we had Sarojini Naidu and Savitri Bai Phule, but we also had Mahatma Gandhi sort of propagating Sri Sakti. So men have always been hand in hand with women for gender equality in India, but now the equation has changed. Like even for this book, to approach men, like a lot of male feminists said no, which is very surprising. I'm not going to name them, but it's surprising to me that men, people don't understand that feminism is not men versus women, but men and women versus a system of patriarchy that has been unjust to both genders. So I think that's the message that we're trying to get across in this book.
Name the guys, na? Be fun.
By the way, your first wife, you created your fake wife, you created a Facebook account.
My first wife. My first wife is,
a tree.
Yeah, is a tree.
So Sorabh, we are both Mangleeks.
Mangleeks.
What is
it's
it?
It's like WikiLeaks over.
I think this is a sangria.
It's like Mangleeks. We are Mangleeks, yes. I don't know, you are a Mangleek.
We have so much in common, that's why we're an unlikely pairing. You basically did whatever I was doing. So I was born a Mangleek. You decided to be a Mangleek. So you had to marry a tree.
Yeah, I had to marry a tree.
And you created a Facebook account for her called Diva Bactri.
Because my wife's name is Eva Bakchi, so I call her Diva Bactri.
And she has a lot of friends.
Yeah,
and
I have forgotten her password now. So because my lawyers told me, hey, leave it all behind.
So your first wife was a tree.
My first wife was a tree. She's
doesn't actually, that say a lot about you?
It does. That I give everyone
you have wood.
We did this joke for a week, I remember. I like the whole, because effectively if the ceremony is about loving nature, I thought it was a nice thing. And I walked around with the Saat Feras and everything with the tree.
You were very excited with that.
It was very fun. I really enjoyed it. I like these kind of things. It's fun.
Marrying trees.
Yeah, I'd love to marry more trees. I mean, like technically, like the thing is that like I'm open to, if you're a tree listening to this show, just know I'm interested in you. And let's what be honest, without you tree, this book wouldn't have been existing. I don't even
exist tree.
Yeah. On that note, I think this unlikely pairing has come to an end. I pick up all our books, Meghna's novels. Our first novel was 1.5 Wife, then Happy Birthday, then Trouble with Women, and the forthcoming
Feminist Rani, Holy 100 Texts, and How to Get Published.
All three great novels. I have a novel, Pawan the Flying Accountant, which is my last one. Goodreads has given it a very humble rating of 3.3, which means it's probably good, I guess.
You're on the right track.
A friend of mine literally said, he's like, bro, I loved your book. Why does it have such a low rating on Goodreads? I'm like, why are you bumming me out and complimenting me at the same time?
If you have above a 3 rating, it's a good thing.
Yeah, my first novel was 2.75.
That's not a good thing.
I gave it that much. No, I love my first novel. It's my favorite thing I've written. And check out my Amazon Prime Video special, which is Make India Great Again. I'm genuinely not very overtly proud of anything I've created. But this is like about 75-80% close to what I want it to be. It's political. It's relatively decently structured. And I'm pretty happy with it. So I think you'll enjoy it. So go check it out. And please subscribe to this channel, which is, of course, youtube.com/pantonfire.
Nice plug. They're going to edit that out.